This video is about the Johnson-Su Bioreactor. The Johnson-Su Bioreactor is a composting system developed by Dr. David Johnson and his wife, Johnson-Su, that results in a high-quality, high-fungal compost without any turning. In this video, I'm not going to try to recreate what Dr. Johnson did in his YouTube video, or explains how to make a Johnson-Su Bioreactor. I'm more going to go over some of the lessons we've learned at the Eco-Regenerative Learning Center, where we make quite a few Johnson-Su bioreactors every year. Listed here, you'll see the YouTube address for the video that Dr. Johnson has. First thing I'd like to let you know is if you're going to be making multiple piles, you want to make a template. Just use a 4x4 piece of plywood and place the circles as described in Dr. Johnson's video. The next thing we learned is in the original version that Dr. Johnson had, he had the Johnson-Su at a full 5 feet of height. We found this very difficult to work with, so we ended up chopping a foot off of the remesh that we used to make the bioreactor. Now, I did talk to Dr. Johnson about this, and he said it was actually not a problem to have the slightly shorter height. I also want to recommend the landscape fabric that you use. Try to avoid that plastic woven stuff that you can get at Home Depot. I find that it just falls apart after a while. Once it starts falling apart, it starts unraveling. It catches on everything. Little bits of plastic will get into the garden. It's just a real pain. We started using this spun fabric. It's a gray material. It doesn't last any longer than the plastic stuff, but it's much easier to handle and you can clean it up better. If you know of any place you can get landscape fabric that will stand up to the sun here in New Mexico, please let me know. When loading your Johnson-Su bioreactor, we found that we really did have to make sure that you soak your materials. We were very fortunate in that our wheelbarrow has a hole in the bottom, so when we just take it out of our soaking tubs, it drains completely by the time we get to the Johnson-Su bioreactor. Now, I know in his video, Dr. Johnson says that we should be have the material as small as possible, you know, like maybe shredding it in a shredder. But we find that, first of all, we found that people out here don't have access to a shredding machine. So we thought, well, we would just make it as other people around here would. It actually still works. It just takes a little bit longer, but it will still work. So you don't need to worry about shredding. The biggest question I have, and I have heard from numerous people on this, is the question about the piles freezing. Where we live at 7,300 feet in west central New Mexico, it freezes solid. The ground will freeze 3 feet deep. There is just no way around us building a Johnson-Su without it freezing. Now, the way we've discovered that we can get around this is we will build a pile mid-late summer into early autumn, keep it going, let it freeze, and then in the spring, which is usually around March when it thaws, we'll start watering it again. By April, we'll make sure that there are earthworms in it and continue the process, and it still works. I'd look at it under a microscope to verify, and it is still good. Now, we don't have the equipment to test or have the money to send off to have the compost tested for the diversity based on DNA sequencing. Now, that might make a difference, but looking under the microscope, looking under there and seeing the amount of fungi, the diversity of fungi, it's still a very good product. Now, after you let it sit for at least a year, you can check the final product by pulling some stuff out of the middle of the pile, squeeze it, and it will start to come together. It feels like putty. It's really very different than other types of compost. Now, if you don't get this putty thing when you're doing it, I'm willing to bet it's because you didn't water it enough. I've heard so many people say, well, it just didn't work for me. And I ask them, well, how often do you water it? And they say, oh, once every couple of weeks. That will not do. The number one reason why this would not work is if you do not keep it wet enough. It needs to be about 60 to 70% moisture at all times. Now, the final product, when you look under a microscope, will have a fungal to bacteria ratio of about 5 to 1 to 10 to 1. There will also be lots of protozoa, lots of bacteria. You know, I've done microscope assessments of compost and soils for years now, hundreds of them, and by far the best compost I've seen are the Johnson-Su Bioreactors. Work in Beauty is a 501c3 nonprofit based in West Central New Mexico. We operate on donations from people like you. Please consider donating money for our cause by either sending a check to our address listed here or through our website at workinbeauty.org. Thank you very much.